This is Cajon Tells a Dog. Real priest got the Bible now. This is Right Knowledge for Vel. This is Tells a Doctrine. This is Yahuwah.
These brothers and sisters are just a few examples, and the list goes on and on and on and on with many artists in the industry. The Illuminati is essentially primarily pop, rap, hip hop, rock, alternative, trap, as their primary outlets for the aggressive one promoting the doctrine of the devil, the doctrine of Satan. You go, I can understand it, believe it or not. Now, I want you to notice that in the hand, think about this, right? They refer to themselves as the light bearers, right? The Illuminati, Masons, the light bearers, right? So think about the Statue of Liberty, right? When you look at the Statue of Liberty, right? I want you to notice in the hand of the Statue of Liberty is a torch. That torch is symbolic to light, being the light bearer. Thus, the Statue of Liberty is symbolic to the light bearer, Lucerfur. Now, I'm gonna make something very clear. Lucerfur is not the devil, but he had that spirit of Satan on him. He was wicked. Lucerfur was the king of Babylon. And this is what Christianity, man, all of you that's caught up into that, come on. You need to go to your pastor, go to your reverend, go to your deacon, go to your preacher and tell him to turn that over to an Israelite congregation so those people can learn the truth, because he's going to have a lot of blood on his hands for a lot of lost souls because you're not teaching the people the truth. You understand? Lucerfur is not the devil. Christianity started that garbage. Modern day Christianity, should I say. Lucerfur is not the devil. That's an age-old lie that fake Christian convert started. The Illuminati calls himself Luciferian. Lucifer is Latin, meaning light bringing, lux, light. You understand? So that's why they use that term Lucifer. That's the only reason. Light bearer doesn't mean the devil, but they worship the devil. They worship Satan, but Lucifer is not the devil. So Lucifer makes his appearance. So those of you who don't know, let me clear that up right now through the spirit of Yahweh Shem Yahweh Shah. Lucifer first makes his appearance, and the only time he appears in the Bible is in the 14th chapter of the Old Testament of the book of Isaiah in the Tanakh at the 12th verse. Nowhere else is Lucifer ever mentioned in the Bible. Stop me when I'm lying. I'm waiting. Where's all the Israelites, you know, think they know son, or you Christian Bible carriers, I told us. Stop me where I'm lying at. Show me any other place where Lucifer is actually in the Bible. And the problem is most people do not, most of you don't understand the Ivri. You don't understand the Hebrew. So the only thing you read is some maybe offshoot Bible, modern day translation, or the King James Version, but you don't go and look it up in the Ivri because you don't study and research the Ivri. So you don't know the difference between Lucifer and the devil when you see it in the Ivri. You understand? Because you've been taught by some damn Johnny come lately Christian that don't know a damn thing. Understand that. So Lucifer makes his appearance in Isaiah, the 14th chapter, verse 12. Nowhere else in the Bible. How art thou fallen from heaven, O Lucifer, son of the morning? So what does a Christian mind do? They took that with the concept of Satan being kicked out of heaven and said, oh, this is talking about Satan. That's a damn lie, man. This is why everybody don't supposed to have the Bible in their hand, man. You don't understand the Bible. The Most High is actually it hasn't been given it most to understand it. How art thou cut down to the ground, which did weaken the nations? So the first problem, check this out, King Queen. Right, listen up, because I'm about to explain something to you that no one ever told you in your life, because you've been lied to most of your lives. A lot of you go to these Bible classes, you think you're winning the truth, you're learning the truth. Stop! You're just wasting your time. So the first problem is that Lucifer is not even a Hebrew word. It's not in the Hebrew. It's Latin. So how did it find its way into the Hebrew manuscript, the Tanakh? Written before there was actually even a Roman language, which is Latin. You understand? So in the original Hebrew text, The 14th chapter of Isaiah is not about a fallen angel, but about a fallen Babylonian king. Stop me, where am I at? Con? So, who during his lifetime had prosecuted the children of Yasha Allah, the children of God. So it contains no mention of Satan whatsoever in that verse. So, neither by name or by reference. So they just put it there. You understand? They just put it there. So, so-called Christians, converts, decided to put that there and said it meant Satan. Doesn't mean Satan, doesn't mean the devil. You see what I'm saying? They created this. The converted church decided for themselves that they wanted the story to be about a fallen angel, a creature not even mentioned in the original Hebrew text. And to whom they gave the name Lucifer. It's not about a fallen angel, it's about the fallen king of Babylon. Why Lucifer? Everybody all right? Why did they choose Lucifer though? What? How many of you so-called Catholics in the world? How many of you Baptists? How many of you Jehovah Witnesses in the world? So on and so forth. Why did they put Lucifer there? Because I know your scholar, your so-called priest hasn't taught you this. So why is Lucifer there? Talk back to me. Why is Lucifer there, brother Eddie? Why is Lucifer there, Dilett? Why did they use Lucifer? Why did they put it there? You understand? Why did they put it there? In Roman astronomy, Lucifer was the name. I'll tell you why. Since no one's asked me, nobody don't have anything to say in the room. The question wasn't rhetorical. I really wanted an answer. So I tell you why through the Spirit. When you look at Roman astronomy, right? Lucifer was the name given to the morning star. The star that is actually known by another Roman name as Venus. Venus meaning the morning star. The morning star appears in the heavens just before the dawn, heralding the rising sun. So the name derives from the Latin term lucum, lucum, fere, bringer or bearer of light. So in the Hebrew text, the expression used to describe the Babylonian king before his death is Helah, son of Shahar, which actually can be translated as the day star, son of the dawn. So the name evokes the golden glitter of a proud king's dress and courts. You understand? Much of his personal splendor earned for King Louis the 14th of France, the appellation the Sun King. How many of you ever heard about King Louis? So the scholars of the Authorized King James Version, you know, to translate the Bible into the current English, did not use the original Hebrew text in that verse, but used various translated, largely by Saint Jerome in the 4th century. I can't make this stuff. Go and do some research on Saint Jerome. You're gonna find out that your brother Todd the Doc still in the truth. See, Saint Jerome had actually mistranslated the Hebrewic metaphor, day star, son of the dawn, as Lucifer. And over the centuries, a metamorphosis essentially took place. Lucifer, the morning star, became a disobedient angel cast out of heaven to rule eternally in hell. The theologians, the writers, the poets, they all interwove this myth, this lie, this false doctrine of the fall. And you so-called Christians, in your tradition, Lucifer is now the same as Satan, which is a damn lie. It's a goddamn lie. I'm gonna say it like it is. It's a goddamn lie because it's a thing that God is damn. I'm not cursing. It's the thing that God is doing. That Lucifer is not the devil. Lucifer is not Satan. Satan and the devil is one the same. But Lucifer is not the devil. It is not Satan. So Lucifer is nothing more than an ancient Latin name for the morning star, the bringer of light. This is why the Illuminati refer to themselves as Luciferians. Do you understand? Now that can be confusing to so-called Christians who identify Christ himself as the morning star, a term used as a century or central theme, should I say, in many of your Christianity sermons. See, Yeshaya, Yahushua Christ, refers to himself as the morning star in Revelations 22 and 16. I, Yahushua, have set my angels to testify unto you these things in the churches. I am the root and offspring of David and the bright and morning star. Do you understand? And so, there are those who do not read beyond the English translations of the Bible who say Lucifer is Satan. And then they'll tell you that it's the word of God. You do err not knowing the scriptures, nor the power of the Most High. You see, this passage is often related to Satan, and a similar thought is actually expressed in the book of Luke, the 10th chapter, verse 18, by Yeshaya Christ, that was actually not its first meaning. Its primary meaning is actually given in the book of Isaiah, the chapter 14, verse 4, which says that when Israel is restored, they will actually take up his taunt against the king of Babylon. Do you understand? So verse 12 is part of the taunt song. So this passage actually refers to the fall of that earthly king and not the devil. Do you understand? Do you understand? So how does this confusion in translating this particular verse arise? So the Hebrew of the passage reads, Hele ben Shakar, which can literally be translated as Shining One, Son of the Dawn. So this phrase, brothers and sisters, means again literally the planet Venus, when it actually appears as a morning star. So, but when we go and read, and I got a Septuagint over there, when you read the Septuagint in Greek, a 3rd century BCE translation of the Hebrew scriptures into Greek, it is actually translated as Hesopus, which also means Venus as a morning star. So how did the translation Lucifer arise, is the question. That's my question to you Christians. See, this word comes from Jerome's Latin Vulgate. You understand? It has nothing to do with Hebrew. Jerome was literally in error. He mistranslated it. He put it in Latin at the time. Lucifer, in Latin, Lucifer actually meant Venus as a morning star. Isaiah is using this metaphor for a bright light, though not the greatest light to illustrate the apparent power of the Babylonian king, which then faded. So therefore, Lucifer was actually equated with Satan until Jerome, it was never used with Satan until after Jerome came on the scene. Nobody ever used Lucifer synonymous with Satan until Jerome came on the scene. You understand? And so later Christians and Mormons was actually equating Lucifer with Satan. This is where you get it from, Christians. This is where you get it from, you Latter-day Saints. So why is the problem still going on? The information is out there. But don't believe me, go and check it out for yourself. Go and do your own research. So the irony is, brothers and sisters, for those who believe that Lucifer refers to Satan or the devil, and you believe they're one and the same, is that the same title, Morning Star, a light bearer, is used to refer to Yeshaya twice in 2 Peter 1:19, where the Greek text has actually the exact same term. You understand? Light bearer. That's also the term used for Yahawashah in the book of Revelation 22:16. Do you understand? So, that being clear, Lucifer is not the devil. Understand that. Lucifer was a man. He was a king of Babylon. He was not Satan. He's not the devil. I really need to clear that up so that you could understand where I'm going with this, and so you could understand why the Illuminati refer to themselves as light bearers. They believe that they're bearers of the light. So this is not a joke, brothers and sisters. You understand? These practices are very real. And I invite you all to learn exactly who the Illuminati is, and you won't think I'm making this up anymore. They are an organization that actually practices and engages in Luciferian doctrines. And they control the mass mind with it. They control the minds of this world with it. And they have an end goal in mind, which is a one world order, which is already starting to take place. Do you understand? Do you understand? So let me turn your attention. I'm going to get to my point. Hopefully, I've already been talking for 44 minutes, but this is necessary through the set apart spirit. So there's a text in the scriptures, right? Found in the Gospel of Matthew, which says the light of the body is the eye. If therefore thine eye be single, thy whole body shall be full of light. But if thy eye be evil, the whole body shall be full of darkness. The Illuminati has an evil eye. That's the all-seeing eye that you see in the dollar bill that Masons think is righteous, but they're following the wickedness of the devil. If therefore the light is in thee be darkness, how great is the darkness? That's the book of Matthew, chapter 6, verse 22 and 23. So in this text, Yeshaya, Christ, puts forth a parable which concentrates on the spiritual principles of light versus darkness, which represents evil. Good versus evil. There's only two forces in this world, either good or evil. You hear me say it plenty of times. Either you're all right or you're not right at all. There is no halfway. You can't walk halfway. You're the spirit out of the mouth. So it is of utmost importance that we actually gain clarity of this issue, because there is much confusion in this day and age. You got people that are selling their souls and they think they're following the light. They call themselves Shriners. They put on the fez and so on and so forth. They cross the burning sands. Oh yeah, I travel for all purposes. When we look at the book of Isaiah chapter 5 verse 20, right? The word of the Most High Yahweh says, woe. The word woe means destruction. To them that call evil good, that's death to you, man. And good evil, that put darkness for light and light for dark. This is what the Illuminati does. This is how the Illuminati got all of these celebrities. This is exactly what is happening in today's world. And for this reason, I pray to cause you to think seriously about where you stand on this issue of light versus darkness. Where are you at? Are you walking in the light, Dilek? Or are you walking in darkness? Are you walking in the light, Brother Eddie? Or are you walking in darkness? Are you in the light or are you in darkness? That's the question. Are you walking in the light or are you in darkness? That's the million-dollar question. What say if you?